If you're only 550, I don't know. That's more not what maps, I guess, right? But what nightmare tier you're in? And that's like nightmare 3, right? That's either the early or the late ones. If you're having trouble with nightmare 3, just farm gates until you feel comfortable to do the latter parts. Honestly, though, like, if you're in nightmare 3 and you're having trouble, go to nightmare 2. Grab yourself a toxic shock and a purge evil from comb enemies and Malthus, respectively. And then use those for Nightmare 3. And even lower eye power versions with good passes are still going to be more than enough. Wait, I want bubble walls, not these walls. I don't really need to show splines on this. I don't know why I'm doing it. I can't specifically recommend it because I don't know what the eye power requirements are, but if you go to the browser, it'll say like recommended eye power and then like the loot's eye power on each of the maps, and just go to ones that are around your 550 and say like you get loot at 570 or 580 and play those maps. Other than that, you know, do what I suggested about the weapons. Do this, get some good coverage there. There we go. Serenadora gets like every lane this way. It's not great in the middle. We'll see. If I have 20 DU, I'll just split it up properly. I'm trying to be DU efficient. I'm gonna do a Frosty per lane and a Split Viper per lane. Same reason as last time. Same dealy. And then one over here. Oh, lost it. Come on, come on. All right, let's get a single proton down. And then we'll put on like a bunch of Skyguards. Stick that up your butt, Quab. Don't mind me. It's nothing personal. Well, let's show splines. Make sure I'm putting this in the middle. Close enough. I'm always tempted to put down like two bubble walls per lane just to get the extra bubbling. Get some more bubbles. Let's do maybe this. This. Gonna go hard into the Skyguards, I think. Let's move that back a bit so if one gets cobalted, the other one doesn't get hit. Now, because I got a little more DU to work with, let's throw in some geyser traps. How much do I got? I got 170 left, 160, 3 lanes, 170, that's 30 per. I can do, I think, 2 geysers. I think I can do this. This is where I really wish I had the geyser bow now. No, I can't. Oh, no. I counted wrong. I'm 10 DU short. I could get rid of one Skyguard. I could do 3 Skyguards instead of 4. And then I don't know what I'll do with the rest of the DU. We'll see. I don't have the Geyser bow. Well, I do, I don't have one I like well enough to use. There, and then we'll stick one up here. Line of sight's real weird with these, so I don't know how this side lane's gonna go, but I think this should cover it fine. And then 40. I don't have the DU though, dude. I'm short like 10 DU. I'm so upset. Nah, it wasn't good enough. Sadly. Okay, I mean, I could do shorter protons. Like, I could get rid of a proton line. Let me just do that then. Fuck it. Which I'm actually like not happy about doing in the middle. Maybe a side lane proton, because the mid lane proton's kind of important. Let's keep the mid lane one. What if I do this? I don't know. Because then, like, I've got 10 DU left over, and I could put the proton. I hate this. I need 10 more DU. It's really bothering me. A lot. Oh, I want quad. I don't want quad blasting at all. Quab can't live. Okay, I'm just gonna do 3 Skyguards. I think 3 Skyguards are fine. This isn't Forest or Wyvern Enthusiast. We don't have like 20 flyers per lane. But yeah, Quab, we're not letting Quab live. Quab was never meant to live with this build. I think actually I'll just put down one more geyser in the middle actually. That'll make up for the bit of the joining of the lanes in the mid, hopefully, maybe. I could have done another Sand Viper too and felt completely justified. Alright, same as last time, I've got Skyguards. Okay, these. Did I use the right split beams? I didn't use the right split beams, let me replace those. Yeah, those are way too healthy. I didn't use the right beams, I'm an idiot. Let's remedy that. I thought their range seemed kind of short. I don't think I have as much segmented extension, or I'm missing one of the passives on my Waller. Which is why it needs a new relic. Though I guess you guys don't see my spreadsheet like I do. There we go. Then we'll get a monk DPS. Knockups. Do these. And we're gonna have to DPS the boss. Actually, Dav, I guess you're just a wall. I guess you'll wall the bosses, eh? Now let's see how this goes. 5.5k deeps on those. I really need the bow. I might go do that off stream, actually. Farm Siphon Sight D. Alright, I need to watch the flyers into this left lane. mean, they're both hitting it. The question is, will they hit too? Damn it, they died too fast. All right, bubble, please. There we go. Three shots. It looks like they're both just single-shotting. And the one on the right, definitely two-shot. It could be a range thing. Okay, no, that's two-shotting. It's two-shotting and three-shotting through the tree. We're good. How the wall's doing? Nothing's even got through in terms of kobolds. Now, do we have the damage to deal with the kobold flyers? No, they're just... they just hate protons. Alright, whatever. Alright, we good. We good. Triple Skyguard. I'm really upset I was 10 DU short for one more. I even, like, got really cheap with my Serenity Auras. You can never know how disappointed I am. The answer is very. I'm very disappointed right now. If anyone wants to join, by the way, you're more than welcome to. We've got two slots open here. Come hang out, get a try to get a good staff for your Frosty Apprentice. They're in flavor right now. Everyone seems to be using them, so not a bad idea to get some good ones going if you're missing it. I'm seeing them all the time. I played a game like earlier where it was Demon Slayer, but he had like a bling bow and a Bastille weapon on his Huntress and his PDT Huntress and his Frosty Tower Apprentice. I was like, dude, why? Nice. Oh, I'm 100 short. Alright, so boss is in the middle. I'm sure you've got that, Davarina. He took a little bit of damage. That's fine. Middle is... neither middle is grounded. That's awesome. Left lane is grounded. Right lane is grounded. Alright, so we don't even have knockups on the side lanes, sadly. Which really sucks. This is a knockup-centric build. So I'm gonna do tier 4 on the Sand Vipers and the Skyguards, and then I'm gonna do maybe Geysers and Protons evenly? I don't know. I mean, I don't think they fire faster with upgrades, right? 5.5. What I should have considered doing is putting a buff beam across them to get some extra defense speed. Oh. Javelin tosser die. It's actually such a bad map for gearing. Only four bosses. Oop. You were hit by a kobold. Let me repair you. That's fine. It's to be expected. You've got the HP to tank a shot. That's why it's not really a bad idea to have a bit of defense health on your Skyguards. If they can survive a kobold, a flying kobold, you're pretty much set for most maps. They don't usually do more than one alive. Maybe it's more with more people in them, but like, if you can, you know, keep an eye on them, you're golden. Like, a kobold that doesn't destroy a tower, even if it hurts it, isn't really that bad. Ideally, I'd be putting these Skyguards kind of like behind terrain, so when kobolds get angry, they'll just blow up on the defenses, or on the walls. The reason I'm not is because, and you guys have probably heard me say it before, but if there's anyone in here who hasn't heard it, Skyguards, if they don't have line of sight, sometimes don't shoot off multiple projectiles. Like, you see the ones up front, they're doing like 3 shots. They can do up to 4, but if they don't have line of sight, they sometimes only do 1. So I can't really reliably hide them behind trees and other things like I like to do. That being said, you pair a Skyguard with like a Sand Viper and Kobolds die. Oh my god, Dev. That was too funny, dude. You're just like, fuck this. Jump down a hole. Fucking amazing. Alright. I think I'm one short on these, and then I'm just gonna do the lanes. Alright, boss is in the middle again. He's already there. Perfect. I think that's everything? Maybe this last one wasn't? Yeah, alright, we're good. How much do these do now that they're upgraded? 9k? Another 3.5k deeps on it. That's not bad. This one's got a mill damage, which isn't a lot considering there's no, like, poison darts, but it's still something. A lot of the work is going to be the split vipers, though. Wish they showed an attack damage on them. Holy. You can observe it, though. You can bring them into the tavern and see your attack damage. Their attack rate displayed is wrong as well. They're definitely faster than 1.25. There I am, just watching lanes again. Ooh, this mage is just, well, is dead now. Going to town on that wall. How are you? Oh, you're the boss. Let me fight you then. Oh, he has a stabbing motion too. That's interesting. Is that on all the javelin tossers? My DPS on him dropped a lot. I lost my buffs. There we go. He's basically dead. If you guys didn't know, DPS Monk is pretty good burst damage. I don't know what's more though, Monk or Dryad. I think it might be Dryad. And even if it isn't, it's close enough that like I'd still say Dryad because it's a lot easier. So many less conditions to fill. That and like, I've done Dryad Burst and it's like 10 mil in 5 seconds or something. And that's without Lich. Like with Lich. Like Monk will do like, a mil or 2 DPS kind of thing. But that's only for 5 seconds or whatever. Poison Tips is up for 8 seconds. In fact, I don't know how long his power-up's up for. So I think it's similar, but I think it might go to Dryad. Because if you can Lich, you're just destroying. Now I've got Sandstorm on my Monk. I don't have quite as much DPS as some other ones do with Poison Tips. But I like Sandstorm so I can run Demon Slayer. Get a bit of speed boost every time I'm running the thing. Running the core ball thing, whatever you call it. The Guardian's gonad. When you kill the Lava Guardian Demon Slayer, one of his balls falls to the ground. And you carry that and launch it at the boss. So I'm gonna do like protons. Oh my god, I'm overloaded with mana here. Let's just do everything then. We're just upgrading everything, I guess. And I've still got so much. Holy frig. Man, fuck me for wanting to do, like, evenly upgraded shit. It doesn't even matter, but... ugh. Alright, and the first geyser... we go. Yeah, Dev, I agree with you. I think I already said it, but I think it's Dryad. It's so good. And like, unless you run out of stars, you just mouse one and you get more stars. Like, I didn't check where the boss was. I assumed you were just gonna handle it. But yeah, like, your burst damage can become sustained damage if you just mouse one in between. You got Storm Gloves and, like, Meowmere or something. You're just never gonna run out. Your Corruption eventually will run out, but, like, even pounding stars, as long as you had, like, the Sphere for reduced Corruption, or Star Power, I guess, consumption, from Corruption form, like, you're golden. More than golden. Like, you can keep that DPS going for a long while. I haven't checked what it is, my sustained DPS, but it's really good too. And actually, this is coming from a guy who's missing a lot of Starfall damage. A man's Shia walk hero. Dude, Herman Crab found a picture of Shia and he put like glasses on him and it actually kind of looked like me. This is a little weird, but also hilarious. Oh, this is fun. Knockups for days! I'm just gonna upgrade Skyguards to get the extra range on them. Let's get more Skyguard lane sharing. Sharing is caring. It's like the internal cooldown for knockups. You can't knock up things like continuously. It's like a second or something after they land. Or enemy's susceptibility to being knocked up, I guess. How much damage? Like 37 kills? How much damage dealt? 8 mil? It's pretty good considering, you know, flyers are pretty not tanky at all. It's like 2k on them or something. 200k, I mean. Maybe. Actually, let's check. Let's look at these flyers. How much health do they have? 229. What about a beetle? 275. Cobalt Kite is... was that like 137? Yeah, they got no HP on them at all. Ugh. Blit. Thank you. Do the Sand Vipers as well. Might as well. I don't really care about doing the back geysers. They're probably not even doing too much. Front one and then the backs are probably just eh. I mean, how many charges do you use? 24 versus 46. Almost double. 70, 29, 5. To be fair though, that's where he's spending most of his time sitting. But not much is going to get past the first one there. He's in the way. Yeah, the front one's doing like twice as much knockup. Oh! Easy build, easy life, Skyguards carrying. I mean, it's actually kind of Split Vipers carrying, but Skyguards carry. Another way to do this actually would probably just to be Frosty Towers and trusting that your Protons are gonna deal with the things that walk off the lane. So you got a pair of Frosty Towers mixed with Skyguards, and things are either going to freeze to death or just get shot out of the sky. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Alright, check out this burst. Most of that damage was me. At the end it dropped there, you could tell. And I'm not particularly well geared for the monk. I'm missing, like, the damage passive on the ring. Alright, this is a grounded lane. Grounded lanes suck. No fun at all. Let's get some knockups going. There you go. This is like Trendy's push for freaking like active playstyles like the Lavamancer and this eruption stuff and the Mystic buffing things, the Dryad and the Corruption. The monk's already at it this whole time. And it's his knockup with the Skyguards. 25k. You're more tank than you are DPS, I guess, eh? I think I only got like 30 or 40k on mine, and I'm a little more ability power focused. It's not a ton, but it's like, high score is so good in either case. Going a bit more damage, going a bit more resist. If you build it right, you can like just literally nothing in a lane and hold it as a Fire Squire. Talk to freaking 13th Saint or Days or no one cares one on Twitch. We'll tell you about their Fire Squire builds. You just get a bunch of like physical and magic resists, get lifesteal, regen, I think. A shield with a good Seismic Slam regen passive. They got nerfed though, the Seismic Slam has a bit more animation at the end. It gets a bit locked in the animation more than it did before, which kind of sucks. A lot. God, this is so, I don't know, I like watching Skyguards do their thing. I think it's pretty fun. Alright! Easy build, easy life, how long are we going for? 3.5? Not bad. I'll be ending it here.